Thank you. Thank you. Time to snag another submine fragment, Guardian. Get in and out before they even know what's hit them. Hive and Exoscience trying to dig out secrets. Part of me just wants to say let Clovis rust, but we're better than that. door is opening now. A Death Singer's dirge. It's Zivu's battle song.
Charge Prime. Grave status, Telemachus.
Thank you.
Lost Salvation is our enemy, but I feel for these Elixni. From what I've heard, becoming a Wrathborn is not a walk in the park. Without her Shrieker, Zeevil Arath will be blind on Europa. You know what to do.
Thank you. working theory proposal. The witness did not begin wide-scale assaults until Savathun's death. It is possible her presence acted as a deterrent, and her death facilitated necessary developments for an invasion.
That coincides with my experience in other timelines. The second collapse always seemed like it was waiting for some kind of trigger. But it's not something that we could have avoided. Maybe some things are set in stone.
Even stone can be eroded, Elsie. You and I must once again take the long view to find victory. The data terminal is located in a subterranean bunker. It contains the most highly classified files in my archives. By design, they have been completely isolated from the network. You must physically retrieve them. Handle them with care, Guardian. Not even Anna knows of their existence. Ahead of you. Clear the area, and I will open the door. Ensuring humanity's survival. To achieve that objective, I engaged in espionage, sabotage, murder, all acts of tyranny, all unforgivable. But one of them was particularly egregious, an order I nearly executed that would have haunted me to this day.
Additional fallen raiders detected. Eliminate them before I unseal the next door.
My gratitude for securing the files. It would have been inadvisable to leave them unattended, given recent developments. I apologize for not disclosing their existence earlier. To do so required a level of trust I have not held for a considerable time. But, as always, you proved equal to the task. The Traveler chose you well. I once employed human agents in a similar manner. I dubbed them Seraphs, granted them access to experimental armaments and armor. At times I wonder if I predicted the Traveler's creation of Guardians, or if I independently deemed my avatars worthy of such responsibility. Whatever my intrinsic reasoning, the results were sound. You and the Seraphs are kindred spirits. Stalwart defenders of your kind. In the past, I have made errors in judgment. Decisions based on faulty premises and flawed moral frameworks. But you are proof that the Seraph Protocol was no such error. Choosing to trust humanity may have been the best of my decisions. I do not know what the ultimate outcome of this war will be. But come what may, we will fight together.
RAS, engage Turing mode. Conversational.
Old habits.
Sorry. I'm so used to you being more machine. More directive-driven and less...
human.
I wish this had come for you at a better time.
I know. I can grant you this one analytical certainty. There is never a better time. There is only in time. We're too late.
You're right. Like always.
I suppose that brings us to another point. I am not always right. I have done things in the name of preserving the human species that are abominable. They were the mathematically correct choice. But they were not the right one. My new exomind pathways have given me an opportunity to review a lifetime of decisions. To weigh them against emotional and moral conceits that I was not, in the moment, capable of comprehending. Others have called me a tyrant.
They're wrong.
They are not. You have given me the ability to objectively see my own value, but also the ways in which my value has imposed a negative sum to the collective well-being of humanity. It is the sum of an equation I am still trying to balance. But that does not mean your work has been in vain. You gave me choice and free will. And I did with it what I thought was right. That is the sum of your life's work. I see now, at the time of our final calculus, the value in that. The value in emotion, in caring, in how humans make both logical and illogical conclusions from the same points of data. And why both are valuable.
Thank you, Red.
No matter what comes in the future, I will always cherish the life.